So, well, this is a bit of a rarity for us. Harry and I fishing together. It's not normally something we do because off camera, we actually really don't like each other that much.
Yeah, this is not going to be enjoyable at all.
Yeah. But ccmoore insisted we had to, we had to fish together for the purpose of this film. So reluctantly,
we're here,
yeah. And we have a two-night session ahead of us.
Trent View.
Yeah.
We're at Trent View and we've had a bit of a walk around and it's busy. I'd say it's busy.
Sergio Ramos.
Yeah, I think there is probably, well, now there is two swims on the entire lake free. And we are actually sitting in one of them, which just so happens to rather luckily be the cabin swim.
I hope we haven't lucked out on this session already, because this cabin swim was already booked out by other anglers and they haven't turned up.
So their loss, our gain.
Yeah.
And yeah, the other swim that was free was sort of up the other end. We've seen one in front of this peg, mm-hmm. and we've seen one sort of in the peg next door. So we know that there's some sort of fish here, and we're going to do our best to catch them.
Yeah, we've had a walk around, chatted to a few other anglers, and it seems like it has been fishing pretty tough the past few days.
Yeah.
Not a great deal of fish caught, just sort of single fish sporadically across.
Sporadically?
Sporadically.
That's not a word.
Sporadically.
Sporadically spaced across
I think
the lake.
Can you merge them two words together? Create a new?
No.
Okay. Yeah. So just a few fish dotted around the lake, really.
Yeah. So we're gonna do our best to put some sort of a hit of fish together. And we better get started.
Yeah.
They got Mary and Mary's mate. In here.
They were caught yesterday as a brace.
Purfield Common.
Yeah.
That's also in here.
Yeah. Black Mirror isn't dead, didn't he?
Definitely not dead. Or the bishop.
Yeah.
So we've got quite a few good historic fish to go.
Yeah.
Three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Yes!
That's the longest game
of my ever. That was proper hard, right? Right, good. I'm on the safe side.
Excellent. Let's get the kick.
So Mark's got the brew on and I'm doing a bit of feature finding. We've sort of decided that where it's so busy and we're doubling up in a swim, we're really just going to fish one spot. So we're just going to fish two rods each and one spot where we're going to put bait, and then maybe we might put bag or singles or zigs elsewhere. We'll work that out later. And I'm just trying to find where we're going to fish out at a fair range. there seems to be a bit of a bar, and it's really rocky on the far side, and then it drops down into a lot deeper water, maybe 20, 25 feet, something like that. I haven't popped a marker float up or anything. But I feel like we just want to be just the other side of that bar where, we're sort of into water now. A lake like this, where it's got really good depths, that's where the fish are going to be finding. That's where it's going to be the warmest in the deeper water. So, yeah, we've also, at about that range, seen maybe two or three show on that line. Not all straight out in front of us, but at that range. So it's as good a place as any. I'm just going to sort of try and pinpoint exactly where on the other side of that bar we're going to fish.
Is this Earl Grey?
Yeah, it's a good brew, yeah.
Is it Lady Grey? Is it Earl Grey? I can't remember whether it was Earl or Lady.
Well, we've done quite a lot of faffing about today, trying to find a spot we're happy with, but we have finally done that, and it's at 33 and a half wraps, so about 134 yards. And while we've been here, we've not seen anyone else fishing at that sort of range at all. And I do think it's going to be an area of the lake that does get neglected. It is out of quite a lot of people's casting range. So hopefully it's an area where the fish do feel safe. And while we've been here, we have seen a couple of fish show in that sort of zone. So hopefully that is where the fish are. I have gone for a really, really simple setup here. Just a simple leg clip setup direct onto the main line. I've just got a really simple pop-up rig there with a 12 mil washed out pink Carp Freak pop-up, and I'm going to fish identical rigs on both rods. Harry and I are going to share a spot because there hasn't been a great deal of fish coming out. We don't want to start spreading bait all over the swim, having a two spots each, anything like that. So we're just going to concentrate on one area and focus all our attentions on that spot. I think Harry's fishing slightly different rigs and presentation to me, but fundamentally we are going to be fishing this one baited area, putting four rods on that spot. So let's get some rigs in place and start getting some baiting.
So, just as, well, sort of predicted that it would be, we'd be waiting for the night for a bite, there's still a tiny bit of light in the sky, and my left-hander, that's actually sort of one of the middle rods on the spot, has gone, which is a really good sign that yeah, everything that we've done, the sort of effort that we put in. We did spend a long time this morning, this afternoon, finding a spot and working out whether we should fish in that deeper water or whether we should come up onto the bar that we're fishing over the back of. And we decided that we'd go in the deep water, and this bite validates that for sure. And it doesn't feel too bad. It's certainly pulling back a bit. Yeah, two bits of yellow plastic fantastic soaked in the carp freak liquid. You'll be pleased to know, Mark. Oh, there it is. I was looking way out there and it's down here. I think we want to put some more bait out. That's nice. Is he in?
Thank you.
Oh, yes. That's a good start, Mark.
That's a very encouraging start.
That's a good start. And there is the first one of the session. A lovely, scaly, mid to upper double. And literally seconds before I had this bite, Mark goes, "Are we catching anything tonight?" And right on cue, a couple of beeps up, a few more beeps down, and this one was on. So the fact that this has come so early on in the night is encouraging. And I think probably put a little bit more bait out, because we didn't put a lot out. We probably put only a kilo across four rods at a long distance out. So we might give them a little bit more now to see if we can catch a few more through the night. So I've just finished topping up the spot, probably put another 20 or so spots out of our little mix. We put probably about 20 in to start, but to have that bite so quickly, I think we thought it's worth giving them a little bit more if they're going to be sort of on it. So,
and it is sounding a lot more encouraging. There's been a lot of activity tonight as we've gone into dusk, into darkness. You can hear lots of fish crashing out there. So, yeah, a lot more activity. So hopefully they will get on it tonight.
I think they will.
Yeah.
I think they will. And I think that's why we're kind of planning on having an early night.
Yeah. Hopefully it'll be a sleepless. Hopefully it'll be a sleepless night.
Yeah, I mean, that would be good.
Yeah.
That would be good. I'd like that.
Yeah,
maybe
no,
not so much yet. So yeah, we're gonna turn in with the anticipation that it could
kick off.
It might not, because actually that bite that I had was the first that we've seen round the whole lake today.
Mm. Just have to wait and see. Well, kind of as we expected, I think I'd been asleep about 10 minutes and when the rods rattled off and we are playing another carp. At least I think it's a carp. Yes, it's a carp.
You have proper top lip, Tim.
Go on, get in the top lip there. You're a top lip banger. There you go, top lip banger.
Well, it's my turn to get in on the action.
got a really nice fat mirror of just over 18 pounds. And this one fell to the 12 mil washed out pink Carp Freak pop-up. So it shows that both presentations are working, which is nice. And as I said earlier, this bite came just about 10 minutes after we're both fallen asleep, and I do think there's going to be a few more chances through the night yet. So there's number three, lovely little dark one. And yeah, we actually had quite a big long period of inactivity. It's half past six now, so it's just getting light. And this has been the sort of first bite. So hopefully it's the start of a few this morning, although it has, I'm told, been pretty much all night bites and not a lot during the day, but we're going to keep on working at it. I'm going to put a few more spots of crumb and corn and maggots out and see if we can keep the ball rolling. Well, good morning. I'm currently enjoying the first brew of the day. And it's been quite a quiet morning. Nothing has happened since Harry caught his fish just before first light. And if I'm honest, I'm not really expecting a great deal to happen during the day. As we move into autumn, it does seem to be that a lot of the bites do tend to switch from the early morning day bites that you get during the summer months. They do tend to switch more in towards the nighttime bites, and that was definitely the case last night. And from speaking to other anglers, I think that has been the case across the lake. But to catch three fish last night, it is a good result. There hasn't been a great deal caught across the lake. It has been tough going. So I'm pretty happy to have caught three fish between us. It shows that we've got the tactics right. And I'm confident that just by plugging away with the same tactics, that tonight can be as productive as last night.
Or more productive.
Don't want it more productive. That's just perfect.
But only three fish, come on.
Okay. Okay. Tiny bit more productive would be good.
So I'm just about to knock up another spod mix for myself and Mark to put out well in advance of the night ahead, so we can get all of our rods sorted and hopefully nick a few more bites throughout the hours of darkness. And one thing that we are doing is trying to keep everything as different to what the majority of anglers seem to be doing on here, whether that be with the spot, with the distance that we're fishing out, or with the type of bait that we're using. We've noticed a lot of people are using pellets on here, and don't get me wrong, the catch reports over the last sort of few months on the fishery pellet have been exceptional. However, it's not fishing very well at the moment and people are still putting a lot of pellet in, and the water temperature's getting cooler, and I just think that the fish are gonna find something that's a bit easier to digest, more acceptable now, rather than a pellet that's got a higher oil content and it's going to be harder for them to actually pass through them. So during the colder months, especially going into winter, and you want to be using something that's really digestible, and this is what we've got. So I've got crumbed up live system there. That's just gone into a food processor at home. I do these in sort of bulk batches. So we're going to put quite a bit of that in, and the live system is an absolutely perfect boilie for this time of year. Really, really digestible, and the carp absolutely love it. So that's crumbed, and we're going to put some 10 millers in as well. So a couple of handfuls of the tens, and then sweet corn. Can't go anywhere without sweet corn, and we're going to put two or three tins of that in. Sweet corn is literally like 90% water, so it's really, really attractive. Obviously gives that visual element, but doesn't fill them up much at all. So we're going to put three tins of that in, and then I have brought with me some maggots as well. These have just been suffocated in the bag, so they look pretty lifeless, and they're not going to wriggle away or anything like that. I find them a lot easier to deal with when you suffocate them in a bag. And I've got about 2 pints there, and I'm going to just add that in to the mix. Obviously maggots in the winter is a massive, massive edge. So give that a big stir around. And that is what you've got. Complete digestibility, loads of attraction, but minimal food content going down in that deep water. So as we've mentioned before, we are fishing probably just over 130 yards out, and that in a normal situation would come with its difficulties. It is a long way to spod. However, in this swim, it's probably even harder. For as lovely and comfortable as the lodge is, you've actually got quite high ground behind you with these steps going off up to the lodge. And with the 13 foot rods that I've got, the sort of momentum that you need to put into the cast, you can't do a step forward, you can't transfer that weight as easily, and equally you can't have a very long drop on your spon. So there's a few little things that I do slightly differently to normal to make sure that I can get that 130 yards every single time. It hasn't come easily. We've had a few mishaps along the way.
Stop making a mess!
But yeah, I'll basically show you what I'm doing. So normally, once I've filled up my spod, I tend to give myself a half a rod length drop, so down to the spigot. However, doing it like that, I'll be emptying it on the steps behind me. So I've actually got just a 3 foot drop there. And it's not ideal for getting the spon moving really, really quickly, but because you've got more of a sort of backswing than you would with a shorter drop, it sort of gives you just enough without emptying it behind you. Equally, for this range, it's completely to do with hand speed. So I'm pushing with my right and I'm pulling with my left as hard and fast as I can, basically. And firing it out there, you can't really transfer your weight because you can't do that step. But yeah, with a few slight tweaks, and it's going out there pretty nicely now. It was a little bit hard work to get used to at the start, but yeah, we're on it now, and every single one's a coconut straight down the same hole.
So we've talked about the bait that we've been applying into the swim, so now I'm going to show you the rigs that we've been using, and they are both very, very simple and pretty similar, if I'm honest. This has been my presentation. It is a straightforward knotless knot blowback rig. It's tied using 25-pound Camatex Soft, going down to a size 5 stiff rig beat point hook. I've just got a small piece of silicone there over the shank to trap the hair in place. And I have got a split shot there, which balances nicely one of my 12mm washed out pink Carp Freak pop-ups. Now, Harry's using an almost identical rig, but instead he is fishing with a plastic corn, fishing it wafter style. Components are the same. He's using a slightly bigger hook, a size 4 stiff rig beat point hook. And that, again, that balances perfectly the two bits of rubber corn, which have been soaking in my Carp Freaks liquid for eternity, I think. Well, at least since the liquid came out. And yeah, both have worked well. So yeah, hopefully they will continue to work as we move into tonight. Now, because we are fishing at some considerable distance using monofilament mainlines, the further out you fish, the more reduced your bite indication is going to be, just because of the stretch in the mono. So it really is important to do everything you can to maximize your bite indication. So here we are fishing with a tight mainline, as tight as we can get without moving the lead at the other end. Also, the sensitivity on the alarms is cranked up to the max. So on these MXs here, so now that sensitivity is on the maximum setting. And you notice here I'm using a heavy bobbin to put more weight on the line to keep it as tight as possible. Harry is using the quiver arm indicators, which puts the line under constant tension. By fishing with a tight line, as soon as the fish picks up the hook bait and moves the lead, it should be registered back to the angler at the other end. It's worth mentioning as well, when fishing in this fashion, you won't receive the sort of indications you will get normally, like liners and double beeps, things like that. Quite often it may just be one or two beeps that will indicate a take. So if you get a single beep on the alarm, generally that means the fish has made a mistake and that is a bite. So we're going into the second and final night of this session, and conditions are a lot different to what we had last night. The air pressure is now through the roof, the sky is much clearer, and it is noticeably much, much colder.
Yeah, and we've definitely noticed a lot less activity out in the lake.
Yeah, for
yesterday,
sure.
There was, well, I say yesterday, last night, there was a lot more fish showing sort of all over the lake. They're really, really well spread, but every 5-10 minutes you were hearing one splash out.
Yeah.
It's been dark for 4 hours now and we've heard maybe 2 or 3.
Yeah.
So it's nowhere near as active out there now, but there's still plenty of time left, plenty of the night and darkness left to come. So we're just going to have to...
Yeah, I can't really call this. I don't know how tonight's going to be. I don't know. I'm hoping there's going to be a chance for just one more before it's time to call it a day. So
I think that would be a result in itself.
Yeah, absolutely. The way the lake's been fishing, if we can end with four fish, I think that would be a nice little achievement, I think. So we're just going to have to wait and see.
Well, I have absolutely no idea what time it is. But I'm playing a fish. This is actually our second of the night. Mark's already had one. Another mid. Oh, you! I've literally just lost it and swore a lot. Oh no! It's come off just down here. That's not very good, is it?
Well, the last time you saw one of us, Harry was in a fit of rage after losing that fish. And rightly so, because it has been really tough going last night. I had a mid-double figure fish, which I slipped back because Brad was not waking up to film that one. Were you, Brad? No, he wasn't. But as you can see, this morning we are flying the victory flag because I've just had another one. It's only just got light, so we're going to have a quick cup of tea, wait for the light to get a bit better, and then we'll take a closer look at it.
Expect that.
Well, I think we had pretty much written it off. I'm not going to lie. Mark's behind me with a big grin on his face out of pure surprisement, I think. If surprisement's actually a word.
Shock.
Shock. Or? No, shock. That we've actually had a bite in the day. Can't believe it. And maybe we've not topped up at all since we put all of that bait out just before dark. I say all of that bait out, it was probably 35-40 spots that we did between us. And perhaps just putting it out there and sitting on it has paid off, because now we've had more bites over that tonight than we did the night before, or tonight and this morning. Yeah, this would be a lovely way to finish the session if I can get it in. It's holding its weight out there actually quite well. Feels a better fish as well. Oh, as soon as it got light earlier, you had that fish, I was like, well, that's it, done. Exactly the same as yesterday.
Yeah.
Never. Never.
That's how we do it.
That's what we wanted to happen all session. Yeah, we haven't put a string of bites together at all, and now we've just had three we had that one about 20 minutes ago. That is a better fish, actually, my one. He is a better fish. Awesome. I better set another net up.
Oh.
Well done, us.
greedy. I think this is the perfect way to end, isn't it, really?
Yeah, I'd like to put them back out now.
I think it's the perfect.
Would it be more perfect if we had like 10 in the next half an hour?
More bites before it's time. I'll reel in.
And we could have a double, double, double. It's gonna be threes up. Threes up out of nets.
That is a carp freak banger. That's what the carp freaks do. They only get the bangers.
There it is. Carp freak firmly in the bottom lip. He's lovely.
In. Oh, that is really nice. Look at that one.
That is awesome.
That's a really nice fish. Yeah.
How's about that?
Good work.
Good work. Oh, yeah. Happy days.
So this is the fish I caught on first light, just before it all kicked off and we had that double take. Got a really nice sort of half linear, really plump half linear. Feels around 17 pounds, something like that. Really nice fish to start the day.
What a way to end, eh?
Yes, couldn't ask for a better finish to this session. We've got a really nice brace of fish here. Mine's probably about...
Scraper 20, I'd
yeah,
say.
Yeah, just over 20. We've weighed yours. Yours is an ounce shy of 23 pounds. But it's not about the weight and numbers. It's
no,
about the love.
It's about the love. Yeah, it's been a very tricky session here on Trent View, and I think that's goes for everyone around the lake. And... yeah, to end with a flurry of activity like that, I think is a right result and just shows that careful bait application at this time of year is very, very important and goes a long way to helping you put some fish like this on the bank.
Well, that's it for our time here at Trent View. It's been a fantastic session, but right now we are going to slip these fish back, hit the road and head off for a breakfast.
Yum.
Yum.
Yum.